The science of today is the technology of tomorrow. Edward Teller. Welcome to Science Euphoria! What you are looking at now is a Xenobot. They are the world's first living robots. Yes, you heard me right, living robots. Researchers from Tufts University, Harvard University, and University of Vermont have created the world's first Xenobots, and unlike any other robot, they are alive. They have been created using embryonic stem cells from the African clawed frog, also known as the Xenopus levis, which contributed to the name Xenobot. So now, the stem cells have been differentiated into hardened skin cells. The hard cells are chosen for the ability of contraction and relaxation, whilst the skin cells are selected for the ability of bonding together to form a physical structure. Then, the team of researchers ran an evolutionary algorithm on a supercomputer based on the data. As you can see, the red and green cells are contracting cells and the blue cells are the non-contracting cells. The researchers had made tons of configurations like this to figure out which would give the best movements. That means only this particular combination of cells will only give this type of movement. And then the researchers physically shaped the Xenobot with surgical precision. This involved hours of laborious work under a microscope. Eureka! The robots could now spin and move in straight lines. So, in this way, the researchers can now mold the Xenobots in any way they want. Researchers believe that in the future, Xenobots, which are about 1 millimeter in length, can eventually travel into arteries of the heart to scrape out plaques. They can also be used to clear the microplastics in the oceans. Researchers also believe that the Xenobots can be positioned in our bodies to destroy cancer cells and also investigate dangerous compounds, among other substances. Xenobots are completely biocompatible. They have a definite lifespan, just as any other living organism. They can survive for 7 days, and if they run out of fuel, which is food, they will die and eventually dissolve. So, all of this may seem absolutely fascinating and desirable, but it's terrifying at the same time, because what if a robot apocalypse occurs?